Hello and good evening to everyone. Today's topic of discussion is systematic transfer plan. So let me first introduce myself to you. So myself, Dr. Amrit Paul, and I also welcome the viewers to my channel, that is Amrit Paul Commerce Lecture Series. So in this channel we generally discuss about the topics related to banking and finance. So I have also previously made many videos related to mutual fund. So this, and in today's topic, in today's discussion, we'll discuss about systematic transfer plan, which makes there are certain features of mutual fund which makes it very flexible, such as systematic investment plan, systematic transfer plan, systematic withdrawal plan. So all these features and all these investment strategies makes the investment in mutual fund very flexible, and it makes the investment in mutual fund very cozy and also very beneficial for the customers who want to take the benefit of market fluctuation, also want regular income by investing in debt mutual fund. So let's begin today's topic of discussion, that is systematic transfer plan. So basically, in a nutshell, if I tell you what is systematic transfer plan, this is basically a investment strategy which investors follow to reap the benefits of both investing in debt related funds or liquid funds or investing in funds which invest in fixed income securities, which gives stable income to the investors, which gives generally stable income to the investors, and also give benefits of capital appreciation by systematically transferring the funds to equity mutual fund. And from this picture, it is very from this picture we can see that from the debt mutual fund, when lump sum amount has been accumulated in debt funds, it has been transferred to the equity mutual fund. So this gives, this basically investment strategy gives the investors an upper hand in getting regular and stable income, and also gives the benefit by investing in equity mutual funds of getting the benefit of capital appreciation as well as an option of earning dividend, regular dividend. So I have already said, so this from this point from this the systematic transfer plan is basically an investment strategy that I have already mentioned. So here you can see that it is an investment strategy which provides the benefit of both investing in debt fund and equity funds. So it is a two in one, you can say. Means you are getting the benefit of investing in debt funds, which will give you regular income, and also you need not have to fear of losing your capital, and also you will invest in equity, and where you will get capital appreciation or growth. So it will invest in such securities or such securities of blue chip stocks, which will give you capital appreciation, where your capital invested will grow gradually. So people generally invest in debt funds with an aim of earning consistent returns. Means we know that there are certain like if debt related funds generally invest in bonds or corporate debentures or money market instruments, which offer a consistent return. Though the return is generally low, but it offers consistent return to the investors, and equities which create wealth. So I have already discussed this. So but here the equity funds, we know that equity is not though it is, it gives us dividend and capital growth, but it is not free from risk. So there are many factors which influence the returns of the equity funds, as there are certain fluctuations due to economy, industry and company related factors. So there are certain factors which influence the returns. For example, if you take the present scenario, the world is going through a pandemic, is under a challenge of facing the pandemic, so with the corona, COVID-19. So here we can see all in all the countries where the COVID-19 effect has been seen, effect can be seen, the stock markets of such countries has been affected, and they have generally the stocks which were selling at a very high price before in the month of December, January, they are now being sell at a very instead a price lower than the what can be seen in the what it was trading in November, December. So this is generally the effect of the COVID-19 situation, where the country is under lockdown. So it is also affecting the, and whole country is literally made to literally asked to stay at home so that they can stay safe, and the industrial production is nil. So there is no production going on right now. So it is affecting the returns in the form of equities, and also company related factor. If we take the industry related factor, the whole economy is put under lockdown. So there is no chance of equity funds to perform good, and also the no employees are not also going to the for their work because of the lockdown. So it is affecting the, it is also influencing the, these factors are influencing the returns of equity funds. So this there are uncertainties in the returns of equity funds. So it affects, and so we cannot be very certain that if you are investing in this particular company, it will get certainly it will get so much return. So we cannot be so assured about that. So it may get negative return also. So STP helps the basically the systematic transfer plan helps the enjoy the benefits of both stable income plus capital appreciation. So here is STP is beneficial for investors who have accumulated a very large amount of money in debt oriented mutual fund, and gives a standing instruction to transfer a fixed amount of money at a fixed interval to the equity mutual fund scheme. So it is basically an exit strategy from one mutual fund scheme to the other. So here what the investor will give, when the investor has accumulated so much amount, huge amount of money, and he wants to invest, he wants to take the benefit of capital appreciation, he may give an standing instruction to the mutual fund agent or the mutual fund to the asset management company to transfer a fixed amount of money at a fixed interval. Maybe the interval may be monthly, quarterly, or half yearly, or yearly. So depending on his risk appetite or depending on his investment objective, he may direct the mutual fund agent to transfer a fixed amount of money to a mutual fund scheme. So these two points I have already said that why the STP is beneficial, because when the investors have accumulated large sum of money and they want to get stable return and a desired amount may be transferred to the equity mutual fund so that they can get growth in investment. So this point has been I have already told. So this is another motive of investing in STP is that when the market has grown significantly and the investors do not know how the market will perform. So this investment strategy is followed so that when the market is when the investors are not sure regarding the uptrend that will happen in the coming quarter. So this strategy is followed exit strategy when a person or when an investor wants to exit from one mutual fund scheme to the other. So this STP provides a very safe route. So here I have cited one example. So here is that there is an investor whose name is Ram Babu, who has decided to invest 2500 rupees every month. So he wants to invest 2500 every month. So he has done what? He invests rupees 500 on the first. So the time of making investment is on the first of the month, fifth of the month, tenth of the month, 15 of the month and 20th of the month. So the 2500 will get invested in this stages till 20th. And this though he is investing through the SIP mode, so he will get, he will also get the benefit, reap the benefits of getting the interest. He will also get the, though the money will be deducted from his savings account, he will also get and he will earn an interest of 4.5%. So here the investor has an option of keeping the transferring the money from his savings account and to SIP mode in fixed intervals, and also he will get and very also get he will get a chance to earn a, get a chance to earn interest at the rate of 4.5%. So now there is another option which is available to the investor. Suppose if the investor parks 2500 at the beginning of the month, so if the lump sum money is invested, that I have discussed already, that if a lump sum money, that is 2500, is invested in a liquid mutual fund, and he gives a standing instruction to transfer this for rupees 500 at a predetermined interval. The interval may be decided by the investor according to his investment objective. So the depending on his depending on his choice, the fixed interval, after the fixed interval, 500 rupees will be transferred. So the Mr. Ram Babu, the investors will get, investor will get the benefit of an SIP and also earn an interest which is higher than the compared to the bank. So you can see that how flexible it is if you are investing through systematic transfer plan. If you are transferring the fund after, suppose if you are accumulated large huge amount of fund and we want to reap the benefit of both investing in debt and equity, then how beneficial it becomes if you are investing through STP. So though we know that the liquid fund generally invests in bonds and money market instruments, so which has the, where the default risk is low. So though the default risk is low, the interest is also very low, because the bonds are generally issued by the government, and in the government, though it is issued by the government, the risk of making default or risk of making default in paying principal and interest is very low, very less, or the chances is very negligible. So though it is guaranteed that the principal and interest will be refunded, so the interest is also generally low. The risk is less. So and I have already mentioned that liquid mutual fund generally invest in money market instruments. So we know what are the money market instruments, that that money market instruments are there which have a maturity period of less than 1 year, just as call money, repo, reverse repo, treasury bills, then certificate of deposit, commercial paper, interbank participation certificate, interbank participation certificates. All these are examples of call money, call and notice money. So all these are money market instruments. So a liquid mutual fund invest in all these instruments because from the name itself we can understand that it provides from liquidity. So here the risk level is very low. Though it is invested in money market instrument, so here the risk is generally low. So if you are transferring the money from liquid mutual fund, and the liquid mutual fund does not charge any fees if you are making a redemption, or if you are transferring the money from one mutual fund scheme to the other. So if you are transferring the liquid from liquid mutual fund, if you are transferring it to equity mutual fund, it does not charge anything. Means that the mutual fund scheme will not charge you a commission at the time of redemption. So there are many mutual funds. I have mentioned that I have made many videos related to mutual funds. So I have made a separate video on load and no load, load versus no load mutual fund. So load no load mutual fund means there are certain mutual funds which charge you commission at the time of redemption, at the time of purchase, or annually, and there are certain mutual funds which do not charge you any commission, but so all this I have discussed in a separate video which you can find in a playlist, which will be more clear regarding the the charges which are applicable applicable regarding to mutual fund. So if you are very curious to learn about it, please do watch this video. So so STP, as I mentioned, is very flexible. It gives you a flexibility of transferring the particular amount weekly. If you are willing to transfer the fund on a weekly basis, you can do that. If you want to do it in a monthly basis, you can do that. If you want to in a quarterly basis, so on a four-monthly basis, if you want to do that, you can also do that. So it depends on you. So so there is also a minimum balance required. So if you are want to enroll yourself in a STP scheme, there are also minimum balance that you have to maintain at the time of enrollment of the fund. So you have to specify, and though it is to be predetermined that when the funds will be fund will be transferred. So here in the in that case, you have to predetermine the dates. You have to means beforehand you have to mention and which date you are going to transfer the funds. So you have to specify that. So here you can take another example that is an investor. Suppose Mr. Vivek wants to transfer 1,000 rupees from a debt mutual fund scheme to an equity mutual fund scheme every month from July 11. So we can, here I have cited another example which from that this STP will be more clear. The conception will be more clear. Here we can see that there is an investor known as Mr. Vivek, and he wants to invest transfer rupees 1,000 from debt mutual fund scheme to a equity mutual fund scheme every month. So he is willing to transfer debt mutual fund scheme to QT at the interval. The time interval is January 11. Means on a monthly basis he is transferring the money. So here you can see there are 450 units. The units he has accumulated 450 units in debt mutual fund, and he wants to transfer it to the equity mutual fund. And we can see that the before transfer the money is zero. There is nil balance in the equity mutual fund, and the NAV value, so that per unit value of debt mutual fund is presently is at 25, and equity mutual fund is 20. So debt mutual fund that will be redeemed from the debt mutual fund account will have to simply do what from we have to divide this 1,000 divided by 25. So we'll get what, so how many units it will be transferred or allotted, it will be 40. And equity mutual fund that will be allotted is 50. So debt mutual fund units that after transfer it will be 410, means the 40 units will be transferred, and he will get this 50 will be transferred to his equity mutual fund scheme. And we can see in the similarly in the next month as well. So debt mutual fund before transfer it is 450, okay. So 450 this equity mutual fund is zero, and here the in January February 2011 the NAV value is 30 for debt mutual fund, and equity mutual fund is 25. So the debt mutual funds to be redeemed from the account is 1000 divided by 30, it will be 33 units, 33.33 units, and equity mutual fund it will be 40. So 450 divided by 33 is 460, and so he is getting 50 plus, altogether he is getting 50 plus 40, this 90 units. So 90 units will be transferred from debt to equity. So this process of systematic transfer plan will continue. So this STP helps, is an investment strategy which helps allows the person to get systematically expose himself to the risk of market fluctuation, and also the fixed amount is transferred at a predetermined time, so this so he will not be much affected by the market fluctuation, though because the market does not remain at same at the time. So in example also we have seen that sometimes the NAV value is less and the NAV value is more. So he is getting, sometimes he is getting more units, sometimes he is getting less. Getting the less number of units he gets depending on the NAV value. So we can see that the investment exposure, risk exposure is generally less when we are going through the route of systematic transfer plan. So systematic transfer plan generally allows the investors to transfer money from one mutual fund to the another at regular intervals. So if a person who is getting a capital appreciation, suppose he has invested in equity mutual fund and he is getting his capital has appreciated and he wants to transfer it to the debt funds. So it is allowed in certain schemes. So there are certain schemes which allow the amount which is capital appreciation amount to be transferred in debt mutual fund. So the STP allows STP gives more returns if you are investing in liquid funds or debt funds, which gives more returns than a normal savings bank account. So in when you talk of returns, generally mutual fund offer more returns, means the interest which will generate or the benefit it will give, it will be more compared to the simple savings bank account. So so investor can so the next point is the investor will transfer a predetermined amount and the fixed amount will get invested in equity mutual fund on a monthly basis. So the fixed amount will be invested at regular intervals in equities where the market timing risk is minimized. Means there may be certain times where the market is the market is not performing well. So and there may be certain times where the market is performing good. So if you are following the STP mode and if you are investing in it through systematic transfer plan, so we are not affected by the market fluctuations very much. So the main advantage of investing through the risk and also if you are following the STP, the risk is minimized. Means the risk exposure is generally less if you are following the STP route. If you are following the STP investment strategy, means we must not worry about market timing, because a fixed amount will be transferred to a particular designated scheme and fixed amount at a predetermined time it will be transferred. So you should not be much worry about the market timing, and if the stock prices are very high then then we will get less number of units, and if the stock prices are less, means it has stock prices less, then we'll get more number of units. So depending, you need not have to worry about the market timing very much. So the main advantages of investing in STPs is the liquidation of assets. Suppose a person have accumulated huge amount of money in a equity mutual fund scheme, and if he withdraws the entire fund in one go, he may be affected by market time. His investment may be affected, or the return may be affected by market timing. Means suppose if the market is stock prices are crash, and it will affect his returns. But if he systematically withdraws the money, depending on his convenience, depending on his need. Then his risk exposure will be less, and suppose he has accumulated a huge amount of money in equity mutual fund scheme, and he wants to earn a stable return, then a fixed amount will be transferred from equity mutual fund to a equity mutual fund scheme to a liquid mutual fund scheme. So he will not get much affected by the market fluctuation and he need not also have to worry about market timing. So next is tax planning purposes. So suppose a person wants to do tax planning or make some saving by making investment in mutual funds. So he can do what? He can if he is invested in diversified mutual funds, so he can transfer systematically a predetermined amount to ELSS, equity linked saving schemes, which offers tax benefit for both individual and Hindu unrelated family. So he can take the benefit of investing in equity linked saving scheme, but it has a lock-in period of 3 years. So he can if his tax liability is more, he can make a saving by investing in ELSS. So it STP also helps in tax planning purposes. As I mentioned that a person if has invested in diversified equity mutual fund and he has accumulated some money and he can systematically transfer from this equity mutual fund to a equity mutual fund to ELSS, and he may take the benefit of tax planning. So presently they have done away with entry loads. So we can see that, as I mentioned, that there are some mutual funds, if you are purchasing the units of certain mutual funds, you have to pay commission. So if you are purchasing the units, if you are investing 1,000 rupees in a front end load mutual fund, so actually the 950 will be invested and 50 will be going as a commission to the intermediaries of the mutual fund. There are certain mutual funds who do not charge anything on the purchase if you are purchasing the units of the mutual fund. So you are not done away, it has been withdrawn. This entry load has been withdrawn, means that the commission has been at the time of purchase, the commission has been withdrawn. But there are certain mutual funds, if you are redeeming your units, it will charge you commission. That is also known as back end load. So if you are withdrawing the money from the mutual fund may charge you commission. That is back end load. So but if you are investing through STP, you need not have to pay exit load. Means you need not have to, at the time of redemption, if you are following the STP route, at the time of redemption you need not have to pay any commission. Because you are transferring the money from one mutual fund scheme to another. For example, here we have cited an interesting example that HDFC mutual fund presently offering the fixed systematic transfer plan and monthly interval capital appreciation systematic transfer plan. So here in these are the examples of certain mutual funds which do not charge any exit load. Means if you are withdrawing the money or if you are transferring the money from one mutual fund scheme to another, so it will not charge you any commission. So the time which is allowed by the investors, or the time that is allowed by the mutual funds to invest a certain money at a predetermined times, is that you can do it on a monthly basis, at a monthly interval, or the unit holders can invest on the first of the month, 5th of the month, means 10th of the month, 15th of the month, 20th of the month, 25th of the month, or quarterly schemes. The transfer facility is available on the 1st, 5th, 10th, 15th, 20th and 25th of the first month of each quarter. So here the timing of investing is you can invest on the 1st of the month, 5th of the month, 10th of the month, 15th of the month, 20th of the month, 25th of the first month of each quarter. So here you have to invest in this period only. So next we can see in the next slide. So there are certain schemes which do not, as I mentioned, that at the time of purchase, certain mutual funds charge you a commission if you purchase the unit. So most transferee schemes of HDFC mutual fund do not charge any commission at the time of purchase of the units. For some transferee schemes like HDFC growth mutual fund, HDFC equity mutual fund, equity fund, HDFC top 200 fund, HDFC capital builder fund, HDFC core and satellite fund, HDFC premier multi-cap fund, HDFC balance fund, HDFC prudence exit loss are charged. So all these schemes that are mentioned here charges an exit loss. Means if you are redeeming the units or if you are transferring the units from one mutual fund to another, you have to do what? You have to pay a commission. Means a commission is charged by the mutual fund. So here if a investor is if an investor is investing and the investment amount is less than 5 crore in value, an exit load has to be paid. Means if you are investing less than 5 crore at the time of redemption, you have to pay 1.25% of commission. Commission that is to be paid depending on the number of units that you have redeemed, or you have to transfer the amount on or before 2 years from the date of allotment. Means if you are willing to transfer the units from one mutual fund scheme to another, you have to do it before 2 years from the date of allotment. So if you are investing it more than 5 crore, if your investment amount is more than 5 crore, then no exit load is charged. Means if you are investing more than 5 crore rupees in a particular mutual fund scheme, then the scheme will not charge you any commission if you are at the time of redemption. So suppose if you are selling it, means redemption means if you are selling the units, the mutual fund will not, the asset management company or the particular mutual fund company will not charge you any commission if your investment amount is more than 5 crore. So if you are investing less than 5 crore, so it will charge a commission at the time of redemption, that is 1.25, and depending on the number of units that you are you have redeemed or you have sell or you have transferred. So and you have to do, if you are transferring from one mutual fund to another, then you have to do it within 2 years from the date of allotment. So that is the condition of certain mutual fund schemes. So thank you. So I request that I have made a separate video on load and load versus no load mutual fund. So you can find it in my channel. So and you can also find it in the playlist of mutual fund. So do watch that channel, that then the conception of load versus no load mutual fund will be very clear, because without that you will not understand what is load, no mutual fund, entry load, exit load. These points will not be clear very much. And I have uploaded a separate video for it. Please do watch it. Thank you very much. This is Dr. Amit Pal signing out. Thank you.